5 years ago, you signed one of your brochures, and I noticed that you had Thug Life written on you. And I never quite understood what was your reasoning for putting it on there. I did have an opportunity to meet Tupac, but what was your rationale for that, to honor him? Can you just elaborate on that a little bit?
Oh, Tupac was a great man. And he's the first mother of the next generation. And as this generation, as an older person, I mean, she's saying that, but I am. But I wanted your generation, essentially, to understand that we mourn with you. And I would not have put when Martin or Malcolm got killed, I was young, and I would not have done that same thing, and it would have been the same thing. But I was watching people be extremely disrespectful of Tupac and his mother, and I was watching a bunch of lies, and I'm just one person, and I'm not a big fan that you can, you know, do everything. I think that I have enough cultural capital to spend some of it, and so I wanted to spend it on Tupac. To help change the language. And I think that what I helped actually was my generation. Because sometimes it's not that they're cowardly or anything, it's just they won't take stance. And so I think, you know, but I think what I was helpful with my generation saying, no, we have to do something. We can't let that boy die by himself. I mean, of course we know him. We knew who Tupac was. If John Kennedy was America's son, Tupac was Black America's son. We knew who his mother was, right? This is a wonderful boy to lose, and I wrote a poem. This is a wonderful young man to lose. And I think in Tupac's case, he was assassinated, and it was an assassination. And I think he was assassinated because somebody said, you know, we're always waiting to kill these Negroes after they made an important impact. So let's just cut this one down, because you can see it coming. And since you have Tupac, we've lost Tupac, you end up with Eminem. You end up with the foolishness. Stood for something. And I'm saying it doesn't matter, like the kids now, I'm happy, you know. But Tupac took it to the edge. And once we cut him down, it has gone in another direction. We miss it. Mm-hmm.